we want to use the binomial theorem to expand the quantity x plus 2 raised to the fifth power. The binomial theorem is stated here below, and while it does look fairly involved, if we look at this in parts, I think we'll see the pattern that will make it much easier to remember. Notice each term in the expansion of the quantity x plus y raised to the power of n has a combination part, and then a variable part that contains factors of x and factors of y. If we look at just the combination part for a moment, or the yellow part, notice how the first term has n choose 0, again where n is the original exponent on the binomial, and then the next term has n choose 1 followed by n choose 2 all the way out to n choose n. If we look at the variable factors, notice how the first term contains n factors of x, which is the exponent on the binomial, and 0 factors of y. Notice how if we add these exponents, n plus 0 does give us the original exponent of n on the binomial. And then for successive terms, we drop factors of x and start picking up factors of y so that when we add the exponents, the sum is still n. Notice the next term has x raised to the power of n minus 1, so it lost a factor of x. It also contains a factor of y to the first, so we picked up one factor of y. And this pattern continues. We drop another factor of x on the next term and pick up another factor of y. So we have x to the power of n minus 2 times y to the second until the very end, where we have 0 factors of x and n factors of y. So let's go ahead and expand our binomial. The first term would have a combination of 5 choose 0, and we'll have 5 factors of x and 0 factors of 2. Next term we'll have 5 choose 1 as our combination, and we'll lose a factor of x and pick up a factor of 2. So we'll have x to the fourth, 2 to the first, plus next term would be 5 choose 2 times x to the third, 2 to the second. Again, notice how these exponents always add to 5, which is our original exponent. Now we're going to have 5 choose 3, and we'll have 2 factors of x and 3 factors of 2, plus 5 choose 4, we'll have 1 factor of x and 4 factors of 2. We have one more term, 5 choose 5, so we know we're done, and we'll have 0 factors of x and 5 factors of 2. Now we've applied the binomial theorem, we just need to simplify this to find our expansion. There is a way to evaluate these combinations using Pascal's triangle, but for this example, we're going to go ahead and use the factorial definition of a combination given here. So for 5 choose 0, we would have 5 factorial divided by 0 factorial times 5 minus 0 factorial, which is just 5 factorial. We have x to the fifth, and 2 to the 0 is equal to 1, plus 5 choose 1 is equal to 5 factorial divided by 1 factorial, 4 factorial, x to the fourth times 1 factor of 2, plus 5 choose 2, that would be 5 factorial divided by 2 factorial, 3 factorial, x to the third, 2 to the second, that's equal to 4, plus 5 choose 3, that'd be 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial, 2 factorial, x to the second, 2 to the third is equal to 8, so we have times 8, plus 5 choose 4, that would be 5 factorial divided by 4 factorial, 1 factorial, x to the first, 2 to the fourth is equal to 16, last term, we have 5 choose 5, that would be 5 factorial divided by 5 factorial, 0 factorial. X to the 0 is equal to 1, 2 to the 5th is equal to 32. Now we'll continue simplifying. Well, 5 factorial over 5 factorial is equal to 1, 0 factorial is equal to 1. So notice how this first term would just be x to the fifth. If we look at these fractions involving factorials, several of them are equal to each other. Notice how this fraction here is equivalent to this fraction here. This fraction here is equivalent to this fraction here. And this fraction here is equivalent to this fraction here. So for this next term, to simplify this, we'll go ahead and show the work. We have 5 factorial divided by 1 factorial 4 factorial. Remember, we can write 5 factorial as 5 times 4 factorial all over 1 factorial times 4 factorial. Well, 4 factorial over 4 factorial is equal to 1, so this simplifies nicely to 5. So if this is equal to 5, we have 5 times 2, that's 10x to the fourth, plus, now we have 5 factorial divided by 2 factorial 3 factorial. So we can write 5 factorial as 5 times 4 times 3 factorial divided by 2 factorial 3 factorial. This simplifies to 1. 2 factorial is equal to 2. 20 divided by 2 is equal to 10. So we have 10 times 4, that's 40, x to the third for the third term. Now remember, these two fractions involving the factorials are equivalent. So if this is equal to 10, we'd have 10 times 8, that's 80, times x to the second, that's 80x to the second. And then again, this fraction here is equivalent to this fraction here, which simplified to 5, as we see here. So we have 5 times 16, that's 80 times x, so we have plus 80x. And then finally, this fraction was equivalent to the first fraction, which was equal to 1, which we should be able to see. So we have 1 times 1 times 32. So our constant term is positive 32. This would be our expansion of the quantity x plus 2 raised to the fifth. I hope this explanation was helpful.